Hey everyone, welcome to Ian and Friends Tour de Suisse Edition. I am Flow Bike Senior Editor Ian Dilley.
And I am Michael Sheehan, Ian's friend. Today, Stage 7, Tour de Suisse. We saw a massive breakaway get up the road. I can't tell you how many riders were in it because
29.
It's 29, okay, Ian counted. That was too much work for me. Well, way to be on that.
It looked like...
it was a third of the race.
It looked like the Peloton. And like when I tuned in, I was like, oh wow, the field is really reduced, but it was actually just the breakaway coming into the final climb.
Yeah, and lots of tactics going on up the road, lots of different teams playing different games. We saw, first and foremost, Joe Dobrowski, homeboy, he put in a great dig up the last climb. You know, we were really like, is Joe gonna win this stage? Yeah. Wasn't to be, but great ride by Joe. He got the most combative award today. Second American in the race to do so, I believe.
Yeah, I kind of feel like Nate Brown was robbed on the most combative award the other day as well. You know, he was really the one to light things up on the climb. We could have had three Americans with most combative, but...
We'll start a petition. so we saw a big battle. Really, the main story is Movistar versus BMC Racing today. Greg Van Avermaet and Victor De La Parte, they both put themselves in the breakaway and were really, really crucial teammates to their leaders, Richie Porte and Nairo Quintana, a few minutes back.
Yeah, so coming into the base of this climb, the Arosa, 29 kilometers long, this climb, but it's really a climb that happened in two parts. An initial 10-kilometer climb that was at a steep gradient, you know, 6-7% with some pitches at 10%. A super long false flat, like 3% gradient, and then a steep final 2K to the finish. And coming into this climb, we saw lead out trains coming into like a 30K climb. It was game on. And Quintana went from the first, as soon as the road started going uphill, he launched, basically did what Richie Porte did yesterday and essentially rode everybody off his wheel. It took him a couple digs to get rid of everybody, but he was gone.
The difference being he had 30K still to race pretty much throughout the throughout the rest of the stage. But yeah, Quintana, he really did what he had to do. He is a pure climber, which is kind of, it's difficult to be a pure climber being as a GC rider, because we're seeing more and more guys who are time trial specialists kind of forcing themselves to become climbers, like Tom Dumoulin. Richie Porte is a very good time trialist. He's going to have a much easier time winning this overall race than Quintana. Quintana just has to go on the climbs. It is definitely his strength, and he played to it. I have to say, Greg Van Avermaet may have saved the day for BMC today, though. He put in just such a smart ride. Like Ian said, the start of this climb was really steep, so that was Quintana's playground. He was able to launch. Team tactics go out the window in Quintana's group. He's just gone. Greg Van Avermaet, because he's 2 minutes up the road, he was able to get over that steep section at his own pace, drop back to Richie, and then when the road flattened out, Greg Van Avermaet really just rode one of the best races I've ever seen from him today as a teammate.
Yeah, all week long, Greg Van Avermaet has been riding really well, really playing a super domestique role in this race. You know, as we've mentioned numerous times, we actually just posted an article about this on flowbikes.com yesterday. BMC is on the hunt for a new sponsor. There have been reports that the end of the Tour de Suisse is kind of D-Day for the team, and the riders will be released to pursue new contracts after this race. This is big contract season for the top stars in the sport. Most of the big contracts are negotiated during the Tour de France. So BMC is really here to put on a show to try and attract a new title sponsor to the team, and Greg Van Avermaet is really being the consummate teammate. Nairo Quintana did have a teammate up the road, Victor De La Parte, but he didn't have near the strike that Greg Van Avermaet did, and Quintana ended up riding this almost 15-kilometer flat section by himself, just pulling around the remnants of the break, like 12 people just sucking his wheels as best they can.
Yeah, Quintana had zero friends up there, and the middle section of this climb before the final steep bit, it really just played into the hands of Greg Van Avermaet, and he ripped it. There's no way around it, and you can really see the impetus that BMC Racing has on this. Just it's crunch time for them. And I think I'm going to go out and say that today, Richie Porte won the whole race.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for anybody, especially Nairo Quintana, to beat Richie Porte in the time trial. Tomorrow is a sprint stage, so we'll see. I mean, the race isn't over till it's over, but it looks like Richie Porte has this thing sealed up. But he did show cracks today. He definitely has dominated this race. BMC has dominated this race. But let's talk about the last 3K because, Van Avermaet launched Richie Porte and he got within, I guess Quintana came into the final steep pitch of this climb with maybe 18, 20 seconds. Mm-hmm. Porte closes it down to 8 seconds before he starts going backwards. And, Fuglsang having a great ride comes up to Porte and ends up sort of saving the day for Porte and towing him into the finish. Richie Porte had a lot of friends today, as you mentioned.
He had a lot of allies on the road. And, we saw Porte, he did crack on the final steep bits. It looked like Quintana really rode a smart climb, even though he was, just pulling around 20 people for like 15 minutes. He apparently saved a bit of legs. And when it got steep, we saw Quintana just get a second wind. Porte rode Fuglsang's wheel up to the finish. He lost, how many seconds did Porte lose? Like 20 seconds?
Around 20 seconds at the end, yeah.
So. And Porte was not too concerned about it. He actually let Fuglsang roll in for second. Didn't worry about the time bonuses on the line. I think that Porte is really confident that he sealed up the overall today.
Yeah, and this is an important ride from Nairo Quintana too. As we've mentioned, there's potential for an internal battle for leadership within Movistar. Mikel Landa, Alejandro Valverde, they're coming to the Tour de France with three-pronged attack, so it was important for Quintana to go out today and assert himself as the leader of this team. We were talking about how a better tactic for Movistar might have been having Landa ride the first part of this climb at a hard tempo to, shell some of the supporters for Richie Porte and try and isolate him a little bit. But that's not, with multiple leaders on this team, they're going to play more of a 1-2 punch type tactic, I'm sure if Quintana had come back, Landa might have launched, but yeah, I mean, Quintana went out and, that's what a leader on Movistar is going to have to do is really just go out and assert themselves.
Yeah, Quintana really put his hand up and said, this is what we're doing in the Tour. I'm the climber, I'm the team leader. Mission accomplished there. I'd say.
So tomorrow, another day for the sprinters, the pure sprinters. We've seen some grumblings from Christoph, Greipel, some of the Flatlanders. Greipel said that he has an allergy to mountains. Mm. Swiss is really bad for his mountain allergy. So tomorrow they actually do a circuit and a valley. A little bumpy. It's only a 120K stage. It'll be interesting to see, how Sagan factors into this. It seems like coming into the Tour, he really beefs up his sort of pure sprinterness. He can go a lot of different directions with his form, so it'll be interesting to see if Sagan is going to be a factor in these pure sprints of the Tour, if he can go head-to-head with Greipel and Christoph.
Yeah, we're going to see some really good foreshadowing before the Tour tomorrow, because it is really, we're doing six circuits, pretty darn flat. It's going to be a pretty straightforward run in into the sprint. We have Gaviria, Greipel, Christoph, Sagan, Michael Matthews, who, by the way, today by going in the breakaway, took the points jersey. So Michael Matthews, we haven't talked a lot about him. He is on really, really good form right now. Last year, he won the green jersey at the Tour de France. And, people could say there's a bit of an asterisk there because Mark Cavendish crashed out, Sagan disqualified. Michael Matthews kind of just inherited the green jersey.
Kittle crashed as well.
So like there was like a domino effect, and Michael Matthews was kind of like the quickest guy left standing. Fair play. I think that he is riding better right now than he was last year at the Tour, and we'll see. I think that he really wants to defend that jersey, and I'm really interested to see how he goes in the sprint tomorrow.
Yeah, Michael Matthews, for as good as he is, he's a guy that gets second through fourth place a lot. But that guy that gets second through fourth place generally wins the green jersey at the Tour de France. So there's going to be a battle for that points jersey at the Tour de France. And yeah, there's going to be another battle tomorrow. Tour de Suisse is all about foreshadowing for the Tour de France. So we will learn some things tomorrow. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, please tune in. Thanks for joining.
See you tomorrow.